Welcome to part one of the Wreck This Journal series today. I'm just going to be working on page one. It doesn't look like there's much to do on this page, right? There's no prompt. But I decided I wanted to go in with some watercolor. At first I was going to use my palette, but then I decided to use my watercolored colored pencils. And so I started filling in the main letters with Mirabeau Order color and just using the watercolor colored pencils, like regular colored pencils, just filling stuff in. Although I knew eventually I'd go back in with the paintbrush and water. And so this is a really fun part, just getting all the basic colors in there before I went over with the paintbrush and the water. So I went in and made the values. It makes them a little lighter and just has a nice watercolor feel, but it feels much more controlled than watercolor. And so I just went in filling that in and just had a lot of fun with it, starting to like destroy the paper, get some unevenness. And just doing stuff like this hopefully will help me overcome like my struggles with like perfectionism in my art. And yeah, I went outside of the line several times while painting this, but I think it turned out really cool. And so next I grabbed one of my pens and started filling in some letters, like the circles and different shapes are in the letters, because this is something I often do when I'm bored and I have papers in front of me, so I decided to do it journal too. And then I had the idea, like, what else should I put on here? Like, I can't just leave it right, like, blank. And so I went in and with my watercolor pencils, still wanted to use those. I'm like, how about I add a paintbrush to start? That's a great one. So I went in with watercolor pencils, kind of sketched out before I started, like, really putting down the pigment. Put that down and using, like, gray for like the bristles and stuff, because I wasn't sure what color I should use. But that's kind of how I use watercolor pencils, just like regular colored pencils, before going in with the paintbrush and water. And I really like how watercolor pencils, they naturally like create these great shadows and highlights in whatever you're working on, and I really kind of like that unpredictability, and it's really nice. And so next I decided I wanted to add some more like art supplies. So I started off with like a yellow like pencil and stuff, because you know everyone uses those in the classroom. Next I filled in a marker, just not a Sharpie, I think it's like a Copic or something like that, with black, and it made just really nice gray color, and it was super easy to like get the color where I wanted it. Next I was like, what else? So I did a red pen. It's like those fancy ballpoint pens that you get at school and stuff. So I went in with that. It was fun watercoloring it, getting the tip, and things still look pretty light, but I'm not nearly done. So this is just like layer one, I guess you would consider it. And then next I was like, I have a pencil, but I don't have a colored pencil yet. So I went in and I added one, just decided to go with this blue color because it wasn't really on the page at that point, besides of course the letters. So I went in with that and used my watercolors to create nice tone and texture. And I decided, you know what, I'm probably going to be doing a lot of erasing, which of course is true. Every artist does. So I went in and did a little bit of a light eraser in the corner. It's kind of hard to see, it's a light gray, but it's sticking out there in the corner, and just used my watercolors for that. And then just thinking, what else might I use? And I was like, you know, I do paper cutting a lot, so maybe I should like include like a little X-Acto knife or like a paper cutter or box cutter. So I added that in gray and black. And after I was all done with that, I went in and added some more details and lines with a thin Copic waterproof marker and stuff. Went in, outlined stuff. I was trying to get for that like messy look in my art, but I'm not really good at that. Somehow, like I can only really do like the really neat stuff, but I think it turned out pretty well. And I ended up adding with a darker pen some like contrast and stuff. And the on like the pen and the box cutter, which I think just made it really stand out from the rest of the watercolor stuff. So, and once I was done with that, I pretty much called it good. So, here's the final result. Thank you for watching. Please like, comment. comment, share, subscribe, and click the link in the description of this video to support my art on my Redbubble shop.